Sunday night, at Clancy took a wife. Was little Bridget Daly who would stick to him for life. He gave a wooden wedding the event to celebrate. Sent out invitations to his friends were poor and great. Each one was supposed to bring a present made of wood. Some of the things they brought were bad and some were very good. It looked as though a lumberyard exploded in the room when Clancy had a wedding made of wood. For there was all kinds of wood brought into the house at night. Hard wood, soft wood, kindling wood for life. Wooden shavings enough to fill a bed. Was brought to Clancy's house when he was 5 years wed. Now the first one to get there was Clancy's cousin Dan. He brought for a present a Japanese fan. Big Jim Maloney as neat as a pin. He brought a cradle for to rock the baby in. Murphy brought a sawn horse and Cassidy a tray. O'Brien sent a cord of wood for which he didn't pay. Dylan sent a keg of beer to keep the spirits up. Happy Joseph Murphy sent a wooden bath tub. There was wood to Cape in China, wood to Cape in Spain, wood from Jerusalem across the raging main, wood to Cape from Russia, sent by the Tsar, wood to Cape from Ireland, enough to build a car, wood to Cape from England, wood to Cape from Wales, wood to Cape from Scotland, the wood to Cape from jail, the pass around the whiskey and the pass around the ale. The glasses wasn't big enough to use a wooden pail. Everyone was feeling good, no one was feeling dry. All were in the glory, and the glory it was high. Someone asked Clancy, would he sing a song? Clancy said he would, but his voice was gone. Big Tim Maloney, he gave a recitation all about the kinds of wood that grew in every nation. The whole such a racket, I can't keep it mum. O'Brien called Maloney an educated bum. Up jumped Maloney and he hit him such a whack. He raised up a hump in the middle of his back. That was a signal and they all commenced the fight. The women hollered murder and they said it wasn't right. Murphy threw the poker and hit a hula hand. O'Brien threw the kettle and he threw the frying pan. Happy Joseph Murphy threw the window door. Maloney sat down on a red hot stove. In came a German to have a jolly time. They asked him to sing, he sang the Bob Tom rhyme. I know it was a finish, but Kelly heaved a sigh. He picked up a rolling pin and hit him in the eye. Next came a Jew for to sing a Jewy song. I knew that something was gonna go wrong. Callahan shouted for everyone to duck. He hit him with a horseshoe just for luck. In came a bootblack that he could sing the best. He started in to sing My Brother Sylvester. Fancy yelled out, let's kill that wop. They started pounding him, I thought they never would stop. Big Maggie Doyle started in to sing a verse. She took an awful chance of flirting with a hearse. Someone hollered, wow, wow, get on through her look. They knocked out a glass eye when she got the hook. In came a colored man, the dog began to bark. He sang a song about coming home in the dark. And again shouted, hire a hall, and they hit him in the head with a big baseball. The ball bounced back, hit Fancy in the eye. Fancy said, I'll get him if it takes me till I die. He started in to get him, but the coon was hard to beat. He ran so fast, he got tangled in his feet. Kelly's Billy Goat came without an invitation. He came butting in just like Cherry Nation. He stood on the floor and they all were in the fence. Then he took the seat out of Sullivan's hands. He butted into Murphy and into Pat O'Brien. He took a shot at Brady and little Maggie Ryan. He butted into everyone until they all were sore. He butted into Clancy, then he butted out the door. All kinds of wood was flying through the air. Brady hit a Brady with the rung of a chair. Murphy grabbed Sullivan and threw him on the bed. Stabbed him with the clothespin and left him there for dead. The police grabbed 25 and 30 got away. Took him up before the judge of any next day. The judge looked him over right before him they stood. He gave him 60 days in jail. They're all sawn wood.